I'm a grown ass man. Grown ass man. I wrote this song, finished this song up probably about 3 weeks ago. And it's a song that's been in the back of my mind for I don't know how many years. Things that I've wanted to say that I hadn't said, didn't have the right melody for it, didn't have the right premise for it. And I felt like I was in a perfect place to bring this record together, you know, just as I am. It tells you exactly where I stand as a man right now. You know, walking through the lyrics, first verse says, you know, they said I could lose a little real and lose count of $100 bills. May that be that small town boy that finally made it out. You know, it says, I think it's where they had me wrong. I want to write my own damn song. And I don't want to move to Nashville, man. I got home. This is what you see is what you get. When you look at me, man, I hope you see as real as it gets. Because I'm a grown-ass man. The second verse is, you know, just it really says some stuff like, you know, well, I ain't no politician. And kissing ass just ain't my style. So if you ask me stupid questions, you might get more than just my dime. Says all you really need to know about where I stand is somewhere between amazing grace, back in black, and simple man. And that's, I mean, it's just, it is what it is. That's where I'm at. And it you know, the song means a lot to me. And the cool thing about that song is they got ready to start writing the lyric sheet for it, or to get the lyric sheet for it. Nobody could find it because it didn't exist. I never wrote the lyrics down. It was all in my head. I've been writing this thing for a couple of years. So that was a pretty neat story about it. I finally got the calls like, man, we cannot find the lyric sheet for this song anywhere. That's because there ain't one. but no, and the way we laid it down, we're ending the entire project with that song. And the way it was recorded, put a room mic up, and some instrument mics and a vocal mic. And that's why the Beatles recorded a record. We had my producer, Dan Huff, you know, we hadn't talked enough about for this record. That man brought this thing to life. And, you know, he's talented beyond measure. But, you know, he sat down with a bouzouki. My guitar player, Jess Franklin, sat down with a dobro. I sat down with the guitar. We played through it a few times and took the best one. You know, it's just raw. It's raw as it can get. No auto-tune or cutting or none of that stuff. You know, the song is what it is. It's simple. It says a lot. You know, and I wanted everybody to really concentrate on the words of it and what it said. And, you know, it says in there, you know, I'm a grown-ass man. You're not going to change my ways. I ain't set in stone, but I'm sitting at red Georgia clay. I was brought up on that book in my granddaddy's knee. You can bet your ass that I know who I am. I'm a grown-ass man. And that, you know, that song says in the whole, all the good and bad and ugly from that record, all the trials, tribulations, and triumphs, all that. It comes down to where I stand right now. And, yeah, I mean, I ain't a kid no more. I'm a grown-ass man, and just as I am. Yeah, I'm a grown-ass.